Let's talk about some of the impact that these micro and macroaggressions have on students of color, especially their well-being.
Ooh, so I think at the macro level, as I said earlier, I think we need to really be understanding that that policies and things that go on in the community really do impact students very negatively. It makes students feel unsafe. Mm-hmm. The rhetoric we have currently in our political, sociocultural system makes students feel really unsafe. Students are wondering if they can complete their education safely here. Mm-hmm. It makes students make different kinds of choices of what colleges they will and won't go to. Mm-hmm. Even as a parent of three children who went to college, I was very cautious and encouraging my children to be cautious about the broader community. Mm-hmm. So I think people assume that when young people pick a college, that they're only picking it for the academic prowess or maybe a sports institution or something in the arts. But as a parent, I'm going to tell you that's not the only thing we're thinking right about. We're also thinking about who's in the community around you, how safe is it, mm-hmm. is there a community of color or whatever your group is, are they nearby? Mm-hmm. Is there a vibrant queer community there, for example? Mm-hmm. Are people going to be ostracized because they're in the queer community? So all of that's going through your mind. And while your primary goal is to get an education, the context in which you're getting that education is also critical. So I think that's really important. I think that we forget, in a way, for me as a parent anyway, you just don't sell the school. You have to sell the town around it.
Exactly.
Otherwise, I'm really worried about that. Mm-hmm. I think at the graduate level, if you're working with, you want to work or learn about certain communities, that becomes really critical too. Well, you have access to that community. Mm-hmm. If you're living in a rural community which has very few people of color and you're training to be a clinician or a counseling psychologist, will you be able to actually find people to work with? Mm-hmm. So I think that's a really important issue.
I definitely agree. Yeah, the community that the institution is embedded in is definitely going to have an impact on those norms that that institution then actualizes, right? And so some institutions might have a greater opportunity for microaggressions to actually occur, depending on the community that they're embedded in and those messages that are filtering through. And I think about some of those direct impacts on mental health and well-being. I review a lot of microaggression studies, many that are not published because there's just so many coming through. Every study that I've reviewed, even the unpublished ones, every study has a direct correlation between the amount of microaggressions the person is experiencing and whatever that outcome is that's being measured.
Right.
So if it's a well-being outcome, such as depression or anxiety or some other type of mental health compromise.
Managing stress.
It even filters into impacting help-seeking behaviors. So the more microaggressions that somebody experiences in their educational context, the less likely they are to seek help from that context, which makes sense.
Right.
Why are you going to seek help from something you think is threatening you already?
Right. And I think that for institutions, they need to appreciate, though, that that's why it's really important to respond to micro and macroaggressions immediately.
Yes.
Publicly. So that I think there's a lot of issues around PR for institutions of higher learning and worrying about if we address this directly and openly, that we'll be perceived as being racist or sexist or heterosexist. But from the perspective of the person who's marginalized, not addressing it openly means it's a well-kept secret.
Mm-hmm.
And we know the secrets are always destructive anyway.
Yes.
So that means we can't really talk about it. And as you said earlier, it's not a safe place to talk about this.
Right.
And then who am I going to? So all that gets internalized, which mm-hmm. really creates more stress, more anxiety, more problems with depression, et cetera.